In Adobe Acrobat, do you know the difference between a portfolio versus a binder and how to create both? Let me walk you through this right now. I have Adobe Acrobat Pro running. I am in the new look. If you are in the classic look, everything is going to work exactly the same on both of these. I know that I'm in the new look because over on the far left, instead of having the word file, it says menu. And also my page view and my bookmarks are over here on the right compared to on the left. Doesn't matter. Let's go and make a binder first, and then we'll come back and make the portfolio. The only reason I'm doing the binder first is I find that most people want the binder usually instead of a portfolio. What is the difference? A binder will simply put every file that you have, it'll convert it to a PDF, and it'll put it in one file. So if you had a Word document, an Excel file, and a PDF, the PDF's already been converted. It'll convert the Word document and the Excel to PDF and then put all three files into one PDF. A portfolio will keep all three files separate. So when you open up that Excel file, Excel will want to launch. That is the big difference here. So let's go and do this. Up in the top left, I have menu. If you are in classic view, you'll go to file, click on create, and combine files into a single PDF. You're going to get this screen right here. Really important. Click on the word options. This determines whether you're making a portfolio or you're making a binder. So if you want to make a binder, make sure save as PDF portfolio is unchecked. If it is checked, you're not going to make a binder. Click OK. You can either go and add files with add files, or you can drag and drop. Just to keep this simple, I have three files. I'm dragging over here. I'm going to let go. I've got a notepad file as the first one. I've got an Excel file called mini charts as the second one. And the third one actually is a PDF already. You put them in the order you want. Let's say that I want to see this Excel file first. You just simply drag and drop and put them in the order you want. And the last step before we make that single file PDF is to click on combine in the top right. I am not going to fast forward or speed up this video. Let's just let this run. It should happen fairly quickly. These are not large files. Perfect. I've got one PDF file. It is called Binder 3 because I've been playing, but you could rename it File Save As. There's my Excel file. Page 2 of this is the notepad file that I had. And finally, page 3 is a M365 Insider blog post that I had made a PDF file of. So everything worked correctly, and I got a total of 10 pages in this one PDF file. I'm going to close this and not save it. Let's go make the portfolio. Same steps, either menu or file. Create, combine files into a single PDF. Go to options. Again, save as PDF portfolio. Here's a cool feature that they've added. You used to not have this. Do I want to convert all my files to PDF? And so I'm still going to end up with a PDF. Everything would be a PDF, but there are separate files inside of it. I don't. I want my Excel file to have to be opened in Excel, Notepad. So I'm going to turn this off, but you could leave that on if you want to. Click OK. Let me drag again. Same three files just to keep it easy. I'm going to leave them, though, in a slightly different order. I actually like the way they're running. Notice Excel was file number 2. Click on combine. Same as before. Done already. So over on the left-hand side, and you can move this around right here. Over on the left-hand side are all your files. There's my notepad file. That's file 1. Here's my Excel file called mini charts. Notice that it's telling me it's an Excel file. Do you want to see this? I'm going to hit yes, preview. I'm going to hit open, and Microsoft Excel opens up. So it's keeping the original native file. Just going to close this, and then here is the PDF right there. So there you go. You can put images in here. I believe you can even put movies and video files in here. So this is a cool feature. It is called a portfolio, though. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe to my channel, and my online training classes are available down below. Have a great day. Thank you.